Hello friends, welcome to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're having a great day so far. Today we have four updates to share with you. First, we'll talk about a new component installed in Starship Launch Tower. Then we'll give you the updates regarding SpaceX drone ship's journey to Panama Canal. Our third update is based on the Mars smallsat mission involving Rocket Lab. And lastly, we'll talk about a multi-orbit sensor planned by DoD and Space Force. So let's begin today's space updates with SpaceX installing the first catching part of Orbital Launch Tower. SpaceX has recently installed the first part of the booster catching mechanism in Launch Tower. This will help the Launch Tower to catch Starship boosters coming back to Earth after launch. Starship Gazer, a SpaceX observer, tweeted, "They added a new machine to the base of the tower. SpaceX's incredible pace in this launch procedure seems much better as they're headed towards completion of building the launch tower in just a few months after they started building it." Musk named the recent mechanism installed on the tower as Mechazilla. The overall design of the complex catching mechanism is still unknown. According to Musk, it seems that the whole mechanism will consist of some gigantic, movable pair of robotic arms, which will be attached to the outer portion of the tower. Musk said earlier that the robotic arms will grab the super heavy booster below grid fins, similar to Falcon 9 grid fins, to secure hold. According to a recent report, SpaceX has already completed building a prototype of a super heavy booster's grid fin section in their Boca Chica, Texas factory. The report also says that two anchor-like structures are also seen that could be used to secure and hold the super heavy booster. The anchor-like structures installed between super heavy grid fin mounts are similar to the structures used in Falcon 9 boosters. The grid fin mounts are installed near the top of the super heavy booster. It's quite probable that SpaceX could land super heavy boosters on the flat end of the tower's robotic arm. And it's worth noting, SpaceX has little scope to recover the booster safely on the arms unless the grid fins attached in the booster are strong enough to play the supporting role in this catch mechanism. Till now, it's known that the recently installed part of the mechanism will help the robotic arms to go up and down, a part crucially needed for full Starship stacking with Super Heavy. This part will also help in the landing of boosters. Some elevator-like structures are noticed on the launch tower, which also help in upward and downward movement of the arm. Let's move to our next update. After 10 days of journey, which began on June 10th, SpaceX's drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You, finally arrived in the Panama Canal. Loaded onto the deck of a large, semi-submersible transport ship, known as Mighty Servant 1, SpaceX's drone ship crossed nearly 5,000 miles to reach its destination. Despite waiting several days in the Bahamas, Mighty Servant 1 completed their journey to the Panama Canal in a short time period. However, to reach the port of Long Beach, they have to cross the canal. The Mighty Servant 1, along with SpaceX's drone ship, waiting outside of the canal's protected harbor, could begin transiting the canal anytime now. Meanwhile, the Panama Canal Authority is preparing a special transit permit for the drone ship cargo because of its excessively large size. The permit will allow the ship to pass through the canal without any problem. It's noted that the gap difference measured between SpaceX's drone ship and the canal wall is slightly less than 1 meter. After transiting the canal, the pair will have to travel around 3,300 miles to reach the port of Long Beach. If the Mighty Servant 1 keeps its average stop speed, then it can complete the trip from Panama City to Los Angeles in less than 10 days. Long Beach, California will soon be welcoming SpaceX's OCISLY, currently making her journey from Cape Canaveral, Florida. No activity here at Pier T as of yesterday, but oh, there will be. Spaceflight photojournalist Pauline Acklin tweeted. On the other hand, SpaceX is also preparing to conduct at least half a dozen polar Starlink launches from its East Coast facilities. As per the company's regulatory documents, however, compared to the West Coast, East Coast Starlink launches will have fewer satellites. A spaceflight photographer, Michael Baylor, recently tweeted, SpaceX will launch polar Starlink launches from Cape Canaveral and Kennedy Space Center, with drone ship landings per FCC filings. Launches could begin as early as July. SpaceX is also set to start launching Starlinks from Vandenberg in the same time frame. That's all for SpaceX today. Let's move to our next update, which is based on Rocket Lab. Last year, NASA funded SmallSat mission to Mars that was not successful and may get a new lifeline through a helping hand with Rocket Lab. The announcement came from the Rocket Lab on June 15. According to that, the company secured a contract from the Space Sciences Laboratory of the University of California, Berkeley to start a new design work on a latest version of the Escape and Plasma Acceleration and Dynamics Explorers Escapade mission to Mars. We heard that the two Escapade spacecraft would take a trip around Mars orbit to study the relation between the solar wind and the planet's atmosphere. Escapade's original plan was to launch as a secondary payload to the main belt asteroid of the same name in 2022. That mission is known as the Psyche mission. However, SpaceX at that moment switched its launch vehicle from Falcon 9 to Falcon Super Heavy, which ultimately changed the trajectory parameters for Psyche. Last year, at a preliminary design review for Escapade, the agency determined that change made it no longer viable to manifest Escapade as part of the Psyche mission. Later, NASA decided to hold the review of Escapade, also known as Key Decision Point C, until the middle of this year. The purpose was to find a new ride. As per that, some rumors came up, indicating that Rocket Lab would somehow be involved in a new version of the Escapade Mars mission. The Rocket Lab made it clear with their announcement that there's no longer a rumor now. The company also said the two Escapade spacecraft, named Blue Gold, would be based on Rocket Lab's Photon satellite bus. "This is a hugely promising mission that will deliver big science in a small package," stated Peter Beck, CEO of Rocket Lab. "Our Photon spacecraft for Escapade will demonstrate a more cost-effective approach to planetary exploration that will increase the science community's access to our solar system for the better." Beck's statement did not disclose the terms and conditions of the deal. On the other hand, despite revealing the value of the contract, Rocket Lab's spokesperson, Morgan Bailey, stated it was a phased contract beginning with design and progressing to a manufacturing stage following agency reviews in June and July. Let's move to our last update. That is multi-orbit sensor planned for Space Force and DoD. The U.S. Defense Department's Space Development Agency and Missile Defense Agency and the U.S. Space Force is now moving forward to build up a multi-orbit network of space sensors that can easily detect and track missiles all over the world from medium Earth orbit. In May 2021, the U.S. Space Force picked up Raytheon and Millennium Space Systems to design sensors for this project. Some portions of this network are already under development and are operational. Within the next year and a half, Raytheon and Millennium Space will design the sensors. After that, the sensors will undergo various tests. On passing, they'll be used. Side by side, the other companies working on similar projects are SpaceX, Northrop Grumman, Lockheed Martin, and L3Harris. SpaceX and L3Harris are making wide field of view missile tracking satellites for the Space Development Agency. Northrop Grumman and L3Harris both are working on tracking satellites for the Missile Defense Agency, which would provide the fire control data needed to launch an interceptor weapon to destroy the hypersonic missile. Lockheed Martin and Northrop Grumman are also working for making satellites for Space Force's Next Generation Overhead Infrared Constellation. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.